We live in an unprecedented period in human history. Science, technology, engineering, and medicine allow us to live in a world that is reliably and efficiently tailored to our needs and wants. We have cars and planes that enable us to travel great distances, vaccines to protect us against dangerous pathogens, electricity and fossil fuels to light our homes and moderate their temperatures no matter where we live, and a seemingly endless supply of food and water. This is, indeed, an extraordinary time to live. But how long will the world's supply of resources sustain our voracious demand for goods and services, and what does this mean for our future and the future of our planet? For the majority of history, humans got by on very little. First, we lived in small and nomadic groups of hunter-gatherers. Later, following the domestication of various species of animals and plants, we banded together into civilizations sustained by agriculture. Although there was significant inequality, human society thrived. Furthermore, our relative impact on the environment and the supply of resources was minimal. Then, in the 18th century, everything changed. The Industrial Revolution was born. Suddenly, new manufacturing techniques allowed us to mass-produce food, clothes, tools, electronics, and medicines. The internal combustion engine gave rise to the automobile. All of these achievements, and others, combined to create the so-called middle class. Since the Industrial Revolution, the world's population, affluence, and demand for materials have exploded and continue to increase at an unprecedented rate. At the same time, greenhouse gas emissions into Earth's atmosphere have increased exponentially due to human activities altering the global climate and sea levels. To top things off, our rate of consumption is now so high that Earth is gradually being depleted of its resources. To combat global warming, environmental degradation, and resource depletion, the United Nations introduced the concept of sustainable development under the Brundtland Commission in 1987. The Commission defined sustainable development as that which meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. Under this definition, three dimensions, namely the environment, the economy, and society, interact in the creation of sustainable solutions. Industry's primary objectives are the development, production, and delivery of products and services, as well as creating value for society. In accomplishing these objectives, industry consumes large quantities of resources and creates enormous amounts of pollution and environmental degradation. Therefore, industry has a crucial role to play in the transformation of our society towards environmental sustainability, particularly in relation to our creation and consumption of products. The importance of industry in the achievement of sustainable development led to the introduction of eco-efficiency by the World Business Council. Mathematically, eco-efficiency is equal to the value of the product or service divided by its life cycle environmental impact. Eco-efficiency improvements in products and services over the last three decades have led to huge technological changes. For instance, old incandescent lighting bulbs were replaced with light-emitting diodes. Televisions which used cathode ray tubes gave way to those which used liquid crystal displays. Increases in fuel efficiency have made cars cheaper to operate. There are many other examples of eco-efficiency improvements in products. So what was the outcome of these improvements? Surely our environmental impact has gone down? The answer is no. It turns out that despite all these innovations, our total environmental impact has gone up dramatically. But what was the reason for this? Well, it seems that the development of technologies that are more eco-efficient than their predecessors has led to us using them in greater numbers due to increases in population and affluence, which are both products of increasing living standards. In addition, technology allowed us to build them in much larger sizes. For example, the largest CRT TV was around 40 inches in size, but LCD technology has allowed us to produce televisions in sizes up to 110 inches, which ultimately has a much larger environmental impact than the largest CRT TV. consequently, the efficiency gains along the way have been wiped out due to the impact caused by the consumption increase. This effect is called rebound. Essentially, these improvements led to problems shifting somewhere else, causing even more problems. For example, building more efficiency into products of very small size, such as LEDs, allowed us to use them in greater numbers. Making cars more fuel efficient enabled people to buy larger models for little to no additional cost and made smaller models more affordable for people on lower incomes. As a result, our roads and public transportation network have become more congested, which has created an even larger problem in terms of resource consumption and has had a bigger impact on the environment. As a consequence of the rebound effect, our understanding of sustainability has changed from relative to absolute. We realized that making things a little better or more eco-efficient does not work. In addition, Earth's carrying capacity is not infinite. There are limits and planetary boundaries to the world's eco-capacity. Hence, the concept of sustainability is absolute rather than relative. This means that all of humanity's activities should stay within the carrying capacity of the planet in order to achieve sustainable development. Meanwhile, our climate continues to warm. Biodiversity is decreasing at an alarming rate, and we are running out of resources. So, what's the solution? From a societal and industrial perspective, how can we hope to meet the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs? We'll cover that in our next video. This video series was supported by UNSW Sydney's Inspired Learning Initiative and produced by Dr. James Vassie with the engineering advice of Professor Sami and Dr. Shiva Abdoli.